Com is now online.
Here's Tempest.
I was just going to say, the white is Tempest. On Medusa, game two. And we, over here, oh, there's that teal again.
Now, the Christmas colors didn't help Pretty last time.
Well, here he is. Here's Pretty around 3 o'clock, and Tempest in the white at 7 o'clock.
This is going to be cool. This map, very interesting. Medusa. We don't see the temples abused as much on this map.
Oh, man, speaking of temples, you remember last week?
Oh, my God. You know, it's funny, because when you're Protoss, let me put it like this. Protoss don't get to knock down the temples as much as, say, Terran or Zerg do, so I just didn't realize how many temples there actually were. Normally, I see them killed by Lurker Spines or splash damage from tanks.
Well, there's the stats. Like we had said, Pretty definitely being the expected winner, but in our tournament, that means absolutely nothing.
Yeah, the fans have been wrong many times. Sorry, fans, it's true.
It's a popularity contest, really.
The fans are wrong more often than I am about in Terran versus Zerg when I'm trying to predict things. I mean, really. But that's okay. We still like you. Please keep watching.
It's the Korean fans.
No.
This time around, it actually is the foreign fans, too. So,
really?
Yeah.
Oh, you guys are messing up, too. We're all messing up.
Again, on GoamTV.net, if you go to the poll section, there was... I don't know if it's still there, but there was a poll for us, the foreign community, to be able to put our little inputs into that. So,
That's good. We're all wrong. Now, Medusa, you got to bear in mind, you don't have a small... Merry Christmas!
It says... The first one says, go ahead and win your 5,000, have a Merry Christmas. And then the second says, go ahead and catch one of the 6 dragons and become a new dragon yourself.
Become a dragon. That's the only way to become
so
a dragon.
So that was obviously 2 signs for Tempest. You know what else is funny? They always sit on the side that the player's at, and they all kind of group together like, hey, are you a Tempest fan? Because I am too. Let's sit over here. You know?
Yeah. That's actually true for all Korean tournaments. They all show up and sit on one side of the side of the player that they're on. Unless you're me, I usually get really drunk and go to the other side and try to start fist fights. But, I mean, that's just how I roll. Okay, we got both players scouting each other. And it looks like we're going to have Manor Pylon! Fortunately, he did get the Zealot first. You can see, actually, that's pretty good by Pretty. Pretty's trying to glitch the Zealot. That's headed towards his base. See, he's mining. He's clicking mine, and then if the probe gets in the way, oh my god, two mana pylons. Then he forces the Zealot to stop for just a second. Okay, well here comes the rush. Excuse me. And what his goal is here is to try to pick off probes and to draw attention away from the pylons that did not prove to be effective whatsoever. That might have actually hurt him more than helped him. Rushing and manor pyloning, there's a real art to it. You got to be really good at it.
Can you explain why they do that? I mean, isn't that a waste of minerals?
Well, the thing is that you trap the probe. If you can trap at least one probe, first of all, they can't mine from that mineral patch they blocked off. And second of all, that probe isn't being used. Third of all, if that's even a correct phrase, third of all, you can get in there with the Zealot and start picking off probes so that pylon stays alive for a long time. And the goal is overall to delay your opponent's economy. One probe can make a huge difference in StarCraft.
It's like they're playing tennis.
Yeah. Except they're trying to kill each other.
The volley of death.
The volley of death. Dragoon, love. It looks like he's going to try to back off. Oh, he's DT rushing. That's actually a pretty smart move. A lot of times if the opponent's manor pylon fails. Oh my god, they're both DT rushing. I love games like this. Yeah, if the manor pylon rush fails, failed, you held it off really easily, you can switch to DTs really quickly because a lot of times they're techs behind. Now, usually in DT rush builds, we see the player expanding at cannons so he can try to keep ahead in that way. I mean, he can get an expansion. He's covered. The DTs will keep the other player stuck in his base. But keep in mind that if you do that, you got to watch the temple location because you can glitch a DT up there if you use a probe on the mineral patches just right and send it into the back of the base. It's true. Now, the goal when you're doing a DT rush like these two guys are doing is you want to make it look like you're goon rushing, which is one of the reasons why we see them sending dragoons out, even though they shouldn't be doing that. Now, neither of these guys, neither, are getting detection. Okay, that guy slept in. He was saying his prayers before he went out. Now, here's one of the reasons why we're not seeing detection, and this game's going to get really, really weird in a second here. Listen to me, guys. This game is going to get really weird here. Nobody's getting detection. A lot of Protoss players nowadays will take a gamble and skip detection because if the other guy doesn't go DTs, he's almost assured to win. Now, I don't know how this game's going to turn out, but this is going to be one of those games that might look a lot like Savior and Pretty.
Okay. Oh, man.
So the DTs are going to cross paths. They're both going to go directly for the probe. Excuse me. I sensed something was there. Now, here's the ideal response to this. You make a forge, cancel all the units you're making, make a nexus and a cannon somewhere else and try to win the game from there by microing dragoons. Neither player has defenses. Let's hope, for Tempest's sake, he doesn't give up before he gets to the opponent's base, because if he gets there, he's going to realize he can be in the exact same position as well.
Pretty has finally put up a forge there, so now...
Now we're going to go to the next phase. He's moving in. We don't see cannons. He's blocked the ramp, though. He's blocked the ramp with the DT. That may cost him the game, but he sneaks up the ramp! Because the probe's mining actually glitched the DT out of the way. He's hiding one cannon over here. No, not hiding anymore. As you see, he's using a wrecking ball on that. Oh, God. What is going to happen this game? This could be a draw. This is going to be really weird. So Tempest is hiding pylons because he doesn't have enough money for the Nexus. Now, bear in mind that, yeah, it does look like Pretty has the bigger army. So he's going to go right down here. The winning conditions for StarCraft are you have to kill all of your opponent's buildings.
So these poor guys are going to have to go around and kill every single building.
But we don't know exactly who's going to win with what. Oh, what are you doing, probe? Oh, no. He really wanted to keep that alive. He probably wanted to glitch one up there and try to head a pylon back there. Now, it does look like Pretty should be the one to win this game.
Well, look.
Because he has more attacking units, he can take out the buildings a little bit quicker.
They're at almost an exact number of minerals right now.
Well, minerals aren't going to matter really anymore because they have no nexus. Well, I mean, I guess they could make a few extra.
Yeah, I was
going to
say maybe like another pylon.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, that's
or something.
True. That's true. Yeah, another pylon. Well, you can see now, Pretty splitting up his army. He's going to take out pretty much all of his opponent's base. Very quickly here. Now, bear in mind, though, that this is such a weird game. I can't believe I'm seeing this. Look, Pretty doesn't... He has one probe. I take it back. I was going to say he doesn't have anything. If he blocks this location off, he does! I think that seals it. He can build one pylon there. Unless, of course... Oh, pylon was taken out. Looks like... Okay, I think that's set. I think it's set in stone. This is one of those games, though, that I can't believe I'm actually casting right now because you never see games like this ever in StarCraft. He puts one pylon up there, and I believe that is it.
I think that's it.
That's the entire game.
So there's five Dark Templars, doing some damage left and right. Where's Tempest 2?
Tempest, I believe we're just taking out the main. Well, I think there's one now that's looking around. And I think Tempest is wondering where the other building is, but even then he doesn't have enough. Doesn't have enough time to take out all the buildings. GG, what a game that was.
That was... You can see the expressions on
Pretty's
both of
like,
these players.
Who's this nerd think he is? I'm pretty. Shit,
and
I'm so good. All right.
I'm sure that was interesting for both of them.
Yeah, yeah. That was probably one of those panic moments. I just want to make that was a weird game. You know, every Protoss player has played a game like that, but you don't normally see a game like that on TV. That was a good game.
I just thought it was funny how they both decided to go Dark Templars. They both decided not to have any detection whatsoever, and then... And it's just like, oh, crap, what do we do now, you know? Wow.
Well, Tempest, you know, I gotta say, though, it was very close. That really just boiled down to who was able to get out a few extra GTs and, you know... hide a few extra pylons in other places. Because Pretty got two extra DTs out, he was able to block off the location and still take out buildings. So I think we're going to have a very interesting game on this map. I still struggle to pronounce.
We have seen it all in this tournament. We've seen games that come down to, you know, last building stand. We've come to games where actually, it was Pretty and Savior, the one where it came down to, like, the three units chasing each other all around the map.
Pretty is generating some very interesting games here. He is barely scraping through. We don't know if he's going to make it through this just yet. But we're going to go on to game three. I don't believe we're going to take a break.
No, it's not. It looks like they're going to start on Shin Chupungnyeong, the new Chupungnyeong.
One-on-one map.
Yes.
Very good map.
So this is it. This is where Tempest makes or breaks his reputation of being, you know, the seventh dragon or whatnot.
Yeah,
you know?
Man, we might have seven dragons now. Maybe too many dragons. We might run out of room for the dragons around here.
I don't know, but we do have a almost dragon killer now, another dragon slayer. Mind being labeled the next dragon slayer after Flash. So, this is interesting. I feel like I'm in like a fairy tale or something. All these dragons and...
But I'm in World of Warcraft right now. Okay, well, they're both confirming that they're ready on this screen, so... I think we're going to get this going whenever our Korean commentators are ready, and Susie and me are not ready.
We are ready. We're not going to get owned.
All right.
I swear.
Get ready. Any second. It's going to start. Pretty against, I know him, Tempest.
Again, Sakai.
For the winner goes on to the round of eight. Final round of eight.